In this video, we're looking at some advanced routing options that are available in Mixcraft 10 Pro Studio only. So a very easy example of this would be if we want to take a virtual instrument and turn that into audio. So one way we can do that is by clicking on this icon over here. It says change instrument. We're not going to change the instrument. What we're going to do is go over to here. And right here, you can see when we hover over it, it says allow this plugin's output to be recorded onto other tracks. So I'm going to click right there. And when the red dot's in there, that means this is enabled. And that's all we have to do in here for now. And then the next thing I want to do is click on add a new track. I'm going to add a new audio track. And it created it all the way at the bottom. I'm just going to click and drag it up to the top here. So it's right underneath my drum track. And I'll just give it a quick name. Call it Rec Drums. All right. So we're going to record this virtual instrument onto Rec Drums and make it audio. And how we're going to do that is click on this little icon right here, recording settings. And for audio inputs, we're going to click there. And you can see now Acoustica Instruments is available to us. And that's what my drum kit is in this song. So I'm going to click on that. And one thing you want to watch is if you're doing a mono instrument, then make sure you choose left or right. This is a stereo instrument, so I'm going to record it in stereo. And you want to make sure it's armed for recording, which it is now. If it wasn't, you would click that. So it's red, we're armed for recording. And I'm just going to hit record and we'll see what happens. All right, it's recorded the output of our drums and made it into audio. And you can see it's a stereo track because we have the two waveforms there, and that's what we want for this one. Let's unarm it for recording by clicking there. And now we're going to mute our drum track and listen to this. We've got drums and they're now audio, and we can edit these like we would edit audio. And a great thing you might want to do with this is if you have an instrument like this Acoustica drum kit and it doesn't output to multi-track, so everything's going to be on the same track, you could just have your MIDI file so it's only the kicks. Then you can record this down so it's just the kicks. And then you could do the same thing so it's just the snares. And then you're going to have audio for the individual drums. And that will really help you to mix your song, because now you can mix each drum individually and add EQ and compression to things if you wanted to. But keep in mind, by doing this, we're bypassing any effects that might be on this virtual instrument track. So let's just go back in here. You can see we have a couple of effects that are on here, and I had them disabled. I'm going to enable them now. We'll listen. Actually, we'll solo it and listen. So say I really like the sound of these effects on the drums and I wanted to record those. Instead of having this as our recording source, I would go to the last effect in the chain, because all of our audio is flowing down. So it's going to hit the equalizer first and then the reverb. So if I just record the output of the reverb, I'm going to be getting the drums, the EQ, and the reverb all together. All right, so here's what our drums sound like with the reverb on. And we're going to record that reverb now by going to this track here, clicking on the little thing so we can bring up the audio inputs. And then we want to select TB Reverb V3 as our audio input. Make sure it's stereo because the reverb is stereo, and we can arm the track for recording by clicking right here. Now we'll hit record and hear what happens. All right, we're going to unarm this for recording. Then we'll just solo our newly recorded drums. And then you can see here I have monitoring on. I want that off because I still have the input set for the reverb. So I'm just going to turn that off and we'll listen to what it sounds like. And here's the other. It may sound slightly different because it isn't going through any of the effects over here. And I might have, see, I have a EQ on here. And I might have some other things going on, including fader, that sort of thing. I've only just recorded the output of that reverb. I know when it comes down to the mixing portion of my projects, I like to work with audio and not work with the MIDI and the instruments in the project. I just like to have everything in audio, and this really helps to achieve that. It can also really help if you want to bring some of these sounds into the Alpha or the Omni sampler, which is something we're going to look at in an upcoming video. But next up, we're going to look at speeding up your workflow by using hotkeys. So I'll see you in the next video.